Today, I'm going to explain the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. And in case you haven't heard of it, the most common version of the Heisenberg uncertainty basically says that you can't know a particle's position and its momentum both perfectly. Instead, the more you know about one, the less you can know about the other. Today, we're going to figure out what that actually means. If you remember way back to the first episode, I introduced you to the wave function, which is a wave that tells us where the particle is most likely to turn up. We said that a particle is most likely to turn up in areas around where the wave function is most intense. So, from the wave function, you can find out the place that, on average, most particles will turn up. But of course, the average by itself isn't that useful. We'd also like to know the range around the average that the particles are most likely to fall into. Well, for a peak like this, it looks like the particles will most likely turn up in this kind of region. To calculate this precisely, though, we use what's called the standard deviation. This number also gets called the uncertainty because the bigger it is, the more uncertain we are about where the particle will be. Now let's talk about momentum. We know that while we're not looking, a particle must take all possible momentums at once. If we plot all the different momentums a particle has, that also looks like a wave. We'll call this wave the momentum wave function. Just like with the other wave function, the momentums where the wave is most intense are the more likely to be measured momentums. At the moment, we don't know how to find this wave, but we'll get to that later. In the meantime, we'll define uncertainty for the momentum as well, in the exact same way we did with position. Again, this uncertainty tells us that if you do a measurement on the particle's momentum, you're most likely to find it in that region. So now the Heisenberg uncertainty is the claim that somehow these two uncertainties are connected. In fact, if you multiply the two, the number you get will always be bigger than this tiny number here. So what does this actually mean? Imagine we managed to get the particle into a state like this. Now we're pretty sure about where the particle will end up. However, as a result, we don't know very well what momentum we'll get if we measure it. So you see, the uncertainty principle is all about prediction. It restricts how well we can predict the particle's momentum and position at the same time. Let's look at a really interesting example. Say we go ahead and measure the particle's position. What happens if we decide to measure the particle's position again straight afterwards? Well, remember that before we did our measurement, the particle was in a superposition of being in many places at once. But once we measure it, we break that superposition, and now the particle really is in just one place. So if we measure it again quickly, it will in fact be in the exact same spot. Okay, but what if we're going to measure the particle's momentum after we measure its position? Now your uncertainty about position is practically zero. So your uncertainty about momentum is very big. This means it'll be really hard to guess the particle's momentum. Still, we go ahead and we measure the momentum and we get some number. But wait, now it looks like we know the position and the momentum of the particle perfectly well, and doesn't the uncertainty principle forbid that? Well, are we sure we know the particle's position? What happens if we measure it again and check? The overwhelming chances are that it will be somewhere other than where it was the first time. Why? Because by measuring the momentum, we actually change the particle's position wave function. The particle went from being in pretty much just one spot to being in many different spots. So you can see we can never pin down both the momentum and the position of a particle. Why is that? The uncertainty principle isn't just something that we add into quantum mechanics in an ad hoc way. The reason it happens is because of a special relationship between the position wave function and the momentum wave function. Well, firstly, it's weird that there should be any relationship between them at all. Usually we think the object's velocity is independent of its position. By that I mean an object can be moving at all different speeds, regardless of where it is. In quantum mechanics, that's just not the case. The position wave function actually contains all the information about the momentum wave function. In fact, it contains all the information about the particle's state in general. Say we're interested in measuring something else about the particle, like its energy, angular momentum, or in the double slit experiment case, which slit it went through. You can calculate what values are most likely to turn up just from the position wave function. In other words, in quantum mechanics, the wave function tells us everything there is to know about a particle. Still, there is a particularly special relationship between momentum and position that makes the uncertainty principle happen. I'd like to explain it to you, but it's a bit of a detour, so I'm not sure if all of you want to see it. That's why I've decided to make two short supplementary episodes that'll explain it. If you're interested, you can check them out, they'll be up soon. All right, see you then.